What's up, guys? Nepenthes here, and welcome back to another FIFA 22 video. Today, for the first video of today, we're going to be discussing these new next generation cards. There's been a lot of issues with these, a lot of hype about them. We're going to look at the boost that they've got comparative to their regular gold cards in the store, and we're going to see what EA talk about them. I think the first thing to discuss is the fact that some of you guys won't have these cards and some of you guys will have these cards. And so just to give you a little breakdown of who's going to get them, everyone is. All of you guys are going to get these pink next generation cards. There are six available: Mbappe, Kamavinga, Bellingham, Foden, Pulisic and Hernandez. As you can see, I got Kamavinga. The reason why they've caused such drama is because Kylian Mbappe was advertised to be a left wing on the next generation card, as you can see there, and he was coming out of packs as a striker. So as a result of that, EA tweeted, "We have temporarily disabled the distribution of the next generation player item pack while we work to resolve an issue. We will update this thread once we've enabled distribution again." So for some of you guys who haven't got this player yet, you will get it as soon as they resolve it. They carried on to say the issue mentioned above was that Kylian Mbappe player item was incorrectly set to a striker when he was supposed to be a left wing. We are working to update the next generation player item pack with the correct version before we re-enable distribution of the pack, which means if you opened your pack and got an Mbappe in the first place, you was mad lucky. Second of all, you're going to get another one as a left wing, which just gives you the option to play him either as a left wing or as a striker, which is pretty nice because you'll get another one. And it says players that receive Kylian Mbappe striker version will receive the correct left-wing version once we have identified the impacted players. This may take some time. Again, updates to be shared when available. So, these next-gen players, they've got released. Everyone will get one. All you have to do is basically log on to FIFA and get one. What do they do and how do they work? Well, here's what EA say. Six of the game's brightest young talents ready to leave their mark on the world stage, meet the next-generation players and discover their defining moment. We don't really care about their defining moments. People just care about getting a player. What is a next generation player item? The next gen player item will contain one item out of the six special next generation player items that celebrate Mbappe, Kamavinga, Foden, Bellingham, Hernandez, and Pulisic's status as up-and-coming stars in the world of football. Their items celebrate a defining moment in their careers today, which brought their talent to the world's attention. What do the player ratings respond to? The next generation items respond to each player's ability at the time of their decisive moment. Does everyone get this? Yes. As long as you played FIFA 22 before January the 14th, 2022, so you can go and log in right now and get yours, you'll be granted a next generation player item on PS5, PS4, Xbox Series X and S, Xbox One, PC, and Stadia starting December 15th, which is now, which is why some people have got them, some people haven't. Even if you haven't played since day one, you'll still get an item in FUT. When will I receive it? So it should be there now, but of course they've had an issue, I guess. Does the offer apply to all versions of FIFA 22? Yes, it does. Do I get to keep the next generation item? I don't know why people would ask that, but yes. And what happens if I upgrade to a new gen console? It just travels with you like everything else does. So there's my next gen player. I thought I had got Mbappe. I hadn't got Mbappe. And there's, so I guess one other thing that EA did that kind of really broke the game as an issue, and I'm gonna have to show you here to kind of not prove it, as if you guys need proof, we'll go on to FUTBIN after and have a look at the in-game stats differences, the boosts that they've been given. But this is why it broke FIFA, right? This is what happened. You can see in the store I have two packs, and you guys might be suffering the same thing. What EA have essentially done is, instead of having all of the packs line up next to each other like normal, they've compiled them and now they're all on top of each other. So for me to see my second pack on console anyway, I would need to open the premium team of the week pack. And you might be thinking, oh, maybe that's just a visual glitch and you don't have a second pack. Well, let me go into the web app for you and show you that in fact, I do have a second pack. And then we'll also go onto FUTBIN and, it's not gonna let me into the web app, is it, with this? Yeah, and then we'll go on to FUTBIN and we'll have a look at the stat differences. And there's a big change for Kylian Mbappe. So if we come here, you can see here now, the same store, go into packs. There it is, the Premium Team of the Week pack and the Premium Mixed Players pack. They are, the pack is there. I mean, I kind of wish I didn't open it now. It's quite pointless, but the pack is there. if you want to be able to open your packs, but not the one that it shows on the front, go onto the companion app or go onto the web app. You will be able to open your packs there. But on the console, it has broken the game completely. The packs all stack like, you know what I'm saying? Like that, rather than like that. Like that makes sense, right? Of course it does. To look at the players themselves, here they are. And so one of the big things, and the thing I think people care about the most, is tell me about Mbappe. The first thing to know about Mbappe is he only has 4-star skill moves, 3-star weak foot. So obviously that is a big change from his 5-star skill moves, 4-star weak foot. So he's been downgraded for weak foot and skill moves. Does he have traits still? Outside the foot shot trait and flare trait is still there. In terms of the card itself, he has lost 7 pace, 8 dribbling, 5 defending, including 10 heading, 10 stamina, including 9 other physical attributes, 6 passing, and 10 shooting, including a lot in some shooting stats. Because this is Mbappe, right? High low work rates, 4-star skill moves with 90 pace like this. I still think that this card will do a job, right? You bang a finisher on him and you've actually got yourself a fun Kylian Mbappe. He doesn't have the 5-star skill moves, so you're not going to be able to sweat hard with him. His physicals aren't the best. His passing is absolutely terrible. But his pace, dribbling, and shooting is still pretty good and still worthwhile. If you did want to boost his passing, you can give him the dead eye, boost up that short passing, boost up that vision. But then obviously his dribbling suffers. And if you did want to just give him some pace and a bit better dribbling, you could go the engine. But I think for me personally, I'd either be looking at a Hunter getting that max pace and good finishing there, or probably, you know, my preferred choice would probably be the finisher. Boost up that dribbling as much as I could, boost up the shooting as much as I could. Accept the fact that his passing and physicals aren't going to be the best. He's already got blistering pace, but the fact that he's 4-star, 3-star sucks for a lot of people. I would still love him. I think he would have been my preferred one. We then got Theo Hernandez. Now, what the most interesting thing for me is, EA's press piece says that the ratings correspond to the moment which made them, like what was their exact terminology? I need to reread it because it doesn't make any sense, right? The item celebrates a defining moment from their careers. What does the rating respond to? The next generation item ratings correspond to each player's ability at the time of their decisive moment. Okay, so apparently Hernandez's decisive moment, he was better than he has ever been in his career ever. Ow. Surely this should be a doubt. Surely, if his decisive moment meant he is an 85 rated, he should be an 85 rated, not an 84 rated with an 85 card here. But hey, that's EA for you. Now, Hernandez has got the same skill moves and weak foot. He has got 1 pace, 1 shooting, 2 passing, 2 dribbling, 1 physical, and 1 defending boost. And of course, his 84 card was brilliant. His 86 card is very good. How much is 86 card worth? 160k. This is probably like a 100k card. If you get this Hernandez might probably be the most valuable card that you're going to end up getting. An anchor chem style on him, great pace, great physicals. I probably actually will go over Shadow to boost up that defending a bit more. Maybe even a Sentinel. Probably would go over maybe even a Backbone. Yeah, boost that passing as well. This is just a brilliant, brilliant card if you get this one. It would be really, really cool. So Hernandez is there and probably the best one. We've then got Foden as an 85 rated. He's been given 1 pace, 2 shooting, 2 passing, 1 dribbling, physical, and defending. And Foden's got, obviously he's got the rule breakers card. He's also got an inform left wing, which is very good. I have used it plenty of times. He is a good card, but he's just, I don't know why this year actually. You just don't see him used much and he's not super desirable. But this is a good card. Again, you got a couple chem stars. Probably personally would go with Maestro on him. Boost up his vision, short pass, long pass. He's got good pace. Stamina's good, physical, otherwise terrible. Dribbling's insane. Shooting from range is very good. Shooting from inside the box is good. And he's got 4-star skill moves. That is a quality card if you do manage to get it. Alternatively, you could go with the Deadeye. I personally wouldn't. I think in this occasion, the Maestro just gives a much better, well-rounded boost. Then got Camavinga. He unfortunately just doesn't... I mean, he's not bad, he's just not great. 3 pace, dribbling, defending, and shooting, 4 passing and physical. I do like his physicals, and I do like his defending as a box-to-box. His dribbling's okay, shooting is terrible. his pace isn't great and his passing isn't great. Potentially a cause for a catalyst here, and then using him as a centre mid. Very nice passing, reasonably well-rounded defending, good dribbling, not great, good pace, not great, and good physicals with the 4-star skill moves. He could be fun to use. You could also give him an engine, boost up that dribbling a bit more as well, maybe a little bit better as a centre mid, but obviously his shooting is terrible. He's well-rounded, but on like the low tier. You've then got Jude Bellingham in a very similar situation. He's been given two pace shooting and dribbling and physical, 3 passing and defending. And quite similarly, his physicals are quite nice already. His passing is quite nice already. His dribbling is quite nice already, as is defending. Again, similarly, you know, maybe an anchor chem style as a DM, maybe a shadow chem style as a DM. Good pace, 6'1", 4-star weak foot. That's not bad. You might want to give him an engine to boost up that passing, boost up that pace, and boost up that dribbling. Again, makes him an 84 centimeter as well. You might just want to give him a shadow and boost up that pace and boost up that defending is pretty cool. But yeah, Jude Bellingham's been given a boost. It would be interesting, very interesting, to see how he feels in-game. He's not quite as good as his in-form. He's like 1 or 2 cards away from being absolutely outrageously good, isn't he? And then last but not least, guys, Christian Pulisic, who of course has already got promo cards, the Fire and Ice promo card here, but compared to his gold card, he's been given 1 pace, dribbling, defending, and physical, 2 shooting and passing. He's got 4-star, 4-star here. And he's 4-star, 4-star here as well. Nice dribbling. Nice pace. Has to be a dead eye on him. Gets his shooting to be real nice. Long shots are terrible. Short passing and vision real nice. Physical's not very good. But pace, dribbling, and shooting. Decent little super sub to have as this pink card. But there you go, guys. So the next generation players are here. As I said, they kind of broke FIFA a little bit because of the pack situation. And the fact that Mbappe came out wrong. He came out as a striker instead of a left wing as promised. And those of you that haven't got your pack yet, just wait, just like give it like I'll say probably 12 to 24 hours and your pack will probably be in store. That is going to be the end of the video for today. If you did enjoy it, be sure to leave a like, rate, and comment, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and we'll be back later on for icon swaps, which has been confirmed today. We'll have a breakdown of that at 6 p.m. I will see you then. Peace.